Ah, this is the isolation board.
Yes.
The splash.
Splash protector for the first scary turn on, basically.
That's a lot of wires.
Yep, it's a little scary, isn't it?
You think it's all gonna fit?
I think this. Yes, the one board over here, I might need to change the shape of the board. Because we have a little space on the one side, I could squeeze it in there. But if we don't chase, put it in there, it's up to Brad to find a spot for it.
It's not my problem.
Well, it's sort of both of our problems, actually, but I'm really hoping you can find a spot for it. Because there's still brackets and things that have got to go in here to hold everything in place. At the moment, things are floating. And the brackets will probably make things more difficult and more easy at the same time. So they will take up space, but they'll also provide us with mounting points for, sensor boards and things. Also, we may just get rid of these sensor boards.
What do they do?
Well, the original idea when I was imagining things to being a bit bigger was certain things, their stuff goes to a particular sensor board, and then we hook it up to the main board using Cat5 connectors. But everything's so close together that it might make sense to just go directly to the main board, and then Jeffrey's found some very nice small connectors that we might be able to use for that instead. So, I don't know. At the moment we're using these guys, and it's great for prototyping and development, and you can unplug something and take it out. But it might make sense to go directly to a small plug in here and plug it.
Yeah, it's more stuff.
Yeah.
Alright, well, looking forward to it all boot up.
Yeah, give me a day or so, I think.
With a lock of smoke.
Yes. I'm big on having no smoke too.